Hello everyone, my name is Oskar Lagerlöfsen and I'm the founder of The Total Living. Now I would like to read out loud the 21st blog post in the One Glance article series covering how to set goals. In the previous post, I mentioned the gap between the vision and current reality. Like any task, there is also a gap between the outcome and the current reality, which needs to be filled by an action, which in this case can be realized by goals. So what are goals really? The vision is the ultimate outcome, but it needs certain criteria to be true. The vision spans your entire life and many different outcomes are needed to realize the ultimate outcome. Just like a human body consists of many parts. The outcomes, the building blocks, so to speak, that are needed to realize the vision, the gaps in various areas, they are called goals. We learned in part 11 that the smallest feasible outcomes are called tasks, and projects consist of tasks across multiple sessions. Goals are the next level, consisting of multiple projects executed either in parallel or after one another. And we can now see the difference between goals and areas. Goals are the ultimate growth and development from status quo to desired reality. Areas, on the other hand, are the ultimate stability. It makes sure that everything still functions properly. You need both growth and stability to become ever flourishing like you want to be. And just like areas have their single document, goals are located in a separate document as well. You review your goals during your weekly update together with areas. You can have as many goals as you want, as long as you check them weekly and make sure that projects and tasks are current. Each week, you update the projects and tasks that the goal prescribes to determine what to do next. But then you might ask, what are the actual differences between goals and projects? Because although goals consist of projects, it is not always clear whether an outcome should be a small goal or an unusually large project. And because projects are not bound to a certain time like tasks are, it can be tricky sometimes to distinguish them from goals since both of them operate on a larger scale. But I will present here some helpful differences. The first one, since you can afford to check your goals less than your current projects once a week compared to every day, one compared to seven, you can use your own practical judgment to determine whether something is too big to check every day or if it's more relevant that it checks every day. The larger outcome should have milestones, which are your project. And the goal is by definition more vague, it's vaguer and needs specific milestones, i.e. projects. An example of a goal could be move abroad to location X by January 2022. However, since it is a large action, it's often helpful to break it down into projects such as register myself for residence, find an apartment or house if you need to, negotiate and sign a contract, get all necessary subscriptions, for example, electricity, trash unnecessary things, clean up old apartment and house, coordinate the plan with person X and Y about moving out. Or you can also install yourself in a new apartment house. It's very helpful for do. And you also know where every important facility are and how to use them, like groceries and banks and stuff like that. And it's also Advantageous have projects called Find Communities to start building your local relationships in order to get yourself included and feel belonged. All of these should in turn clarify the doable steps to realize projects and ultimately the goal. As you can see, the largest outcomes tied to the vision can be so vague that milestones are needed. Another example of a goal is hitting a certain yearly target for a company, both in revenue, profit, size, and the number of customers. This overarching goal requires many milestones, such as launching new products and marketing programs, investing in your salespeople, hiring new people for new roles, making the processes faster and easier, getting featured in X conventions and magazines, and etc. These milestones are both in parallel and after another. I recommend that you draw a mind map if there are multiple projects tied to a goal and see how they affect each other along the way. Of course, it's not necessary that you should do it. It could be helpful if you feel like you need to like have everything clear and visualized. So that's just a little tip, not necessary what you need to do. But we also have another key difference between goals and projects, and that is the inclusion of repeated tasks. Projects, by definition, consist only of novel and unique tasks. But on the other hand, goals can consist of both novel and repeated tasks. So they can be both, while projects need to be only one. The outcome can be realized by milestones and step-by-step tactics, or it could be an accumulation of steady inputs. Many goals are, in fact, a culmination of habits over a long time. And these include losing weight, reaching a certain strength in the gym, or a certain speed when you're running or doing other kinds of activities, accumulating the desired social life, or learning a new language and skill in general. These consist of repeated tasks or habits, such as exercise, going out and spending regular time with people, or spend regular time learning. Popular authors such as James Clear are against goal setting because of it, because it's very often that you obsess over the goal instead of what you actually need to do every day in order to make it happen in the long run. So they recommend focus on system and habits instead. But with the one glance system, you receive the ultimate win-win by using the calendar, which tracks your habits. It tracks like, okay, you're going to exercise at this time, and you're going to learn at this time, etc. And you also have the goals document, which you can check every week to see like, okay, how is it going? It's going fine, continue. Or if you need to do some adjustments. So goals serve more as a direction rather than being the whole crutch. Thus, you can have your cake and eat it too. Have a clear goal broken down to foundational habits. So how do you set goals? Because if you click this video and podcast episode, you might have realized that sooner or later the answer must come. And now it is. Start with reading your vision document, which you crafted yesterday, and write down everything that's not true yet. Depending on how ambitious you are, there can be a lot of gaps yet to be filled in all aspects of your life. And I recommend, as I mentioned last time, that you have to be really ambitious in order to make some true waves in your life. For everything you find that is not true yet, you then ask what grand outcome or outcomes are necessary to make it come true that you can act upon right now. Many goals are often required after another, since reality can present many things you did not expect. You might change your mind about stuff. In addition, if you have a little bit more smaller goals, for instance, like 3 months, 6 months, and 1 year as the most, and instead of like 5 to 10 years. The sense of progress is better felt, thus giving you a valuable boost in both motivation and self-esteem that things are moving in the right direction. For instance, if you want to become a billionaire, you can set an initial goal, such as receive a valuable promotion by month Z, or becoming economically able to manage my company full-time by month Z, or have X amount by savings by month Z. After you reach that goal, whatever it might be in your case, you can set new goals, such as another promotion, a certain target for your company, or a new savings goal, all to preserve a sense of progress. In terms of format, you treat it as a project page, almost, but vaguer in action steps since they are more projects. So instead of projects having minimum next actions, you have goals having minimum next projects. And you also need a deadline, which could be a month rather than a day, the desired outcome, and some notes about the projects that need to happen. And if you're watching this on YouTube, you will see now a real example of a goal that I have. So as you can see, the minimum next projects are quite vague, for such as like, okay, clean the old apartment out and move over the rest. What does actually mean in practice and stuff like that? But it's all accompanied by the same direction, which such successful transition to Gdynia. And it is fine that it's quite vague, because projects are more specifically defined in the weekly view. So I can get away with having it a little bit more vaguer on the goal side, because it's more specific on the project side. And I also trust that I will check this goal once a week to update the progress, add new projects, projects and progress, kind of like the same word, or delete redundant ones. Here's another goal of mine, which is more related to habit accumulations, which is reach B1. It's a degree in language proficiency in Polish, Polskiego, by January 2022. And so I have an outcome, like I can understand most what others are speaking, and I can formulate responses and stuff like that. But you can argue that because it's more of a habit plan, spend 30 minutes each day doing whatever I feel like, as long as Polish is included. It's not like milestones, step by step, stuff like that. You can argue that this goal did not need to exist, and you could track the areas, the habit in areas. And that is true, except for the outcome. The goal makes me aware that I need to reach a certain level by a specific month, like a reminder. So in other words, it has a direction that is necessary to review. And you can always check the original articles, because there the pictures are there. By writing your goals in this format that I just showed you and reviewing them during your weekly update in the same document, you automatically fill the SMART criteria, thus making your goals very effective. They are specific, because you describe the outcome and the next projects and habits, stuff like that. Measurable, because of the next projects and habit plan, plus a regular review. Achievable, because these are goals you can act upon right now. This is very important. Relevant, because they are directly tied to your vision. And time bound, because of the deadline. So in conclusion, you have just become hyper strategic. Not only unstoppable, but you know where you're going. Based on your vision, you know what to achieve in the long term and can visualize it happening. You now have a direction in your life that helps you navigate all decisions you need to make and know what's important to know to grow to the next level. The goals are also helping you prioritize and focus. And I will end with a quote from productivity guru Tiago Forte about goals. What many people don't get is that the value of goals is not in the future they describe, but in the change in perception they foster. They serve as a forcing function, helping you steer towards sources of information and opportunities that bring you closer to what is truly important to you, end quote. Tomorrow's video and episode will introduce a longer update, which will detail how you translate your goals and areas from the vision into the real world. You'll also know how to use the longer view the right way. And with that, I want to say thank you for your attention and have a very nice day. See you in the next one.